Because of the pandemic, there is a part of Minnesota that is essentially cut off from the rest of the United States. And that's what we're talking about this morning with Joe Henry from Lake of the Woods Tourism. He joins us live over Zoom. Thank you so much for joining us today, Joe.
Good morning. Thanks, Adam.
And we're talking about issues up at the northwest angle. It's the northernmost point in the contiguous United States. And Joe, what makes it such a unique place and in such a kind of a unique predicament this morning?
Yeah, well, you know, the northwest angle is that little tip of Minnesota that sticks up into Canada. It looks like that little chimney of Minnesota. And, you know, in order to drive to the northwest angle, in order to travel by vehicle, you have to travel through Canada and then enter back into Minnesota, per se. And, you know, the problem is that with the COVID epidemic going on, the border, the U.S.-Canada border is shut down. So consequently, tourists can't get to resorts. So in essence, the resorts are, as you can imagine, very, very much struggling.
So are the resorts able to come up with any sort of workarounds? Like, how are they doing this year?
Well, you know, the only workaround is that you can stay in Minnesota by going on the lake up to the northwest angle. The challenge with that is that's about a 40-plus mile trip across great big waters of Lake of the Woods. It's almost like it's a great lake. It's a small ocean, you know, and not everybody has the boat to do that. There's safety concerns. People don't feel comfortable doing it. You know, a lot of times when you go on a trip, you have people and gear and maybe not the ample boat. So there are a couple of shuttle services that are helping bring people across. But as you can imagine, whenever you add the cost of a shuttle service going across that many miles and just it's not working real well. And people are used to driving up.
So if you have 40 miles on the water, I mean, have you found many people who are willing to do that?
No, not a ton. You know, some are. You know, we're probably at about 10% of what normal occupancy be, maybe 15 in some cases, but about 10% of what normal occupancy would be during the summer. So for all practical purposes, I mean, as you can imagine, our angle resorts are struggling. And, you know, really, they're caught in a unique situation between two countries. I don't know of any other part of the United States that's got the same kind of predicament going on. There is a geographic area in Washington State that has some similarities, but they don't have the business community like we do. We have about a dozen resorts up at the northwest angle.
Wow, a dozen families' livelihoods might be at stake then. So I understand you've been talking to politicians, talking to people in power, and you said that you've been trying to sort of figure out a workaround. Have you made any headway on that?
Well, you know, we're hoping so, but you know, it's a process. So, you know, we've certainly been dealing with our U.S. legislature trying to find some kind of a program, such as perhaps a forgivable loan program that would at least help these businesses, whether it's resorts, guides, other small businesses in that northwest angle area, just to kind of hang on and get through. And so we've dealt with, you know, certainly Colin Peterson, Senator Klobuchar, Senator Tina Smith, Tom Emmer, and others. And we're working any angle we can to try to get some kind of a package through. So that's one avenue we're working. And of course, the other avenue we're working is there's about a 45-mile stretch through Canada that you have to travel through to get to the northwest angle. And we're working with, you know, both U.S. and Canadian officials to try to work something out there. You know, it's I don't know that Canada has a lot of benefit to allowing us to travel that 45 miles when their own resort community is struggling also. We're going to keep working on that. We're going to keep working on the, you know, forgivable loan program, and hopefully something will pop for the Northwest Angle Resorts. You know, the other thing too is we don't know if there's an end in sight. I mean, this thing keeps getting pushed back another month, another month, another month. And what that means for resorts is that you got a full book of business for the summer. That means you got to call every one of your customers and say, gosh, I'm sorry. We have to push it out another month. Oh gosh, I'm sorry, we now got to put it out another month. And you can imagine now nobody knows, are we going to be open this fall? Are we going to be open this winter?
There are a lot of questions, and I know you also said this. There could be a lot of issues that kind of have a ripple effect years down the line. Like, how could a lost season this year affect these resorts 3, 4, 5 years down the road?
Well, you know, when you think of a small business, and you know, if you're an entrepreneur, you work so hard for every customer that comes to your resort. You know, that means phone calls, social media, spending money on advertising and marketing. That means going to sports shows in the off season. I mean, there's so many things you do to build up your clientele. And just like that, a pandemic hits, you're caught between two nations. So it's very unlike other Minnesota resorts where people can still go now and recreate. You can't even get there. So consequently, their customers hypothetically are going to other places, and let's face it, some of them are going to like it in those other places and maybe never come back. So it's not just right now that we're losing. You know, we're losing revenue down the road too. It's a very tough situation for just the hardworking Minnesota resorts.
Well, thank you so much for shining a light on a unique problem from the pandemic here in Minnesota. We appreciate your time, Joe.
Thank you, Adam.
Thanks for joining us. And we're back with your Week in Review and one last check of the weather after the break.